Ho, boom.
Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another random liquid nitrogen experiment. It's getting close to that time where we celebrate our independence. And to help us do that, I've pulled a comment from Thomas Dopkowski, who asks, what will happen if you dip fireworks in liquid nitrogen? Now, I've actually seen this request pop up from a number of different people, but I went with Thomas's comment because he gave me the peace sign and the crown emoji. You know by now we do random liquid nitrogen experiments on a very regular basis, so why not throw a batch of fireworks into liquid nitrogen and see how they react? Now, this is actually very close to an experiment I've wanted to try myself for quite a while, and that is putting black powder or gunpowder in liquid nitrogen. How will it react? Will the gunpowder go off at all? And if it does, how will that affect the performance of the fireworks themselves? So here's the basic idea of our experiment today. I went and found this little styrofoam cooler that we can use to fill up with liquid nitrogen, and it is the perfect size for dipping down a batch of fireworks and letting them cool down to cryogenic temperatures. Once they're sufficiently cooled down to liquid nitrogen temperatures, we're gonna use a pair of tongs to reach in and grab them, where we'll pull them out and get that fuse lit as quickly as we can. Will the fuse ignite? Will the fireworks light? Will the whole thing explode? That's what we're here to find out, because you asked. Now to get started, let me show you some of the equipment we're gonna be working with today. We're gonna start off with some of these mammoth smoke grenades. I'm gonna light them by themselves so you can see how they react under normal conditions. Then we're gonna freeze them and light them off under liquid nitrogen conditions and observe the difference. Next, we're gonna test out some of these artillery shells. These are basically mortar action where we light them, drop them in a tube, and they shoot themselves off. And we're gonna finish our experiment today with this pack of aerials. If anything goes wrong, well, that's your problem. So here we are, I've got all of my smoke flares lined up on these bricks. We're gonna light them all off at the same time, watch them burn, and repeat that experiment again, but this time with them frozen completely solid. All right, here we go. Beautiful. That was cool. I used a blowtorch so I could light them off quicker, but shooting straight down into them, one actually exploded into my face. And apparently we didn't judge the wind direction correctly because all the smoke blew toward the cameras. But you can see they have a slow, steady burn. They all went for about the same period of time and put off very beautiful colors. That was four smoke bombs, four successes. Now let's dip them in the nitrogen and see if that makes a difference. Here we go, red, yellow, green, blue, taking a bath, making a splash. 3, 2, 1. This is where it all happens. Let's go ahead and take this container closer to the brick so we can take them out, set them up, and light them off before they have any kind of a chance to warm up. There's blue, green, yellow, red. In 3, 2, 1. The blue one's going off, kind of. Huh. So look at that, guys. They all kind of stopped. I mean, as soon as the fuse got inside there, it went out completely. You can see these things are still very, very cold because they're vaping, but nothing's happening. I wonder if I just lay on them with the blowtorch if I can get them going. Oh, there goes the red one. Look how thick that smoke is. Come on, yellow. Okay, now they're warming up. Now they're warming up. Spewing hot ash down my gloves. Ooh, ouch. That was interesting. I'm not sure if you saw that, but once I got my blowtorch right down in there, I actually did get the red one and eventually the green one to go off. And initially, the smoke that was coming out was actually very thick. It was very condensed. It wasn't that energetic, fluffy smoke like we saw in the first round. This was a lot more condensed. Now, the blue and the yellow, I haven't been able to get them to go off yet. I'm going to try one more time and see if we can actually light them. But at this point, they've already warmed up a little bit. So I'm not sure how that's going to affect things. Here we go. Oh, there goes the blue. And look how slowly that's coming out. I mean, it's not burning very vigorously at all, but it seems like as the mixture starts to heat up, then the energy grows quickly. All right, so we got the blue one to go off. The yellow one's like still a bit frosty, still a bit hard, but we haven't been able to get it to go off yet. I think that's because there's no fuse left to burn down in there. I'm gonna give it one more shot. If that doesn't work, we're just gonna break it in half and see if we can light off that way. Actually, you know what? That sounds like more fun, so let's just go ahead and break it in half anyway. Yeah, look at that. Let's go ahead and freeze this one more time, just for kicks. Oh wow, look at that. It's actually turned our liquid nitrogen yellow. Maybe that wasn't the best idea. It's like all my smoke powder came out and it turned the whole batch orange. That's crazy.
There we go.
Yep, just a really slow reaction. It actually took quite a bit of heat to get that thing going. And it's definitely got a thicker, more condensed smoke. Even with that wind, you can see how thick that is. Okay guys, so lighting smoke flares have been submerged in liquid nitrogen. Not extremely cool, you can see it definitely slows the reaction, but can we just talk about how putting the powder in the liquid nitrogen colored it yellow? I mean, look at this, the whole batch right now kind of looks like a batch of orange tang. That was an unexpected result. And I guess goes back to answering that question, can you color liquid nitrogen? Well, if you suspend colored particles in it, apparently you can. Now I wonder if we poured some of this out, would the liquid still be orange? So, just poured out some nitrogen, and looking at the cup there, I don't really see any coloring. So apparently that's just the coloring that went down to the bottom and made it appear like it was orange. The actual nitrogen itself is not colored. Whoop, there goes the glass. Look at that. So smoke flares complete. Next up, artillery shells. Here we go, lighting off one single artillery shell. Man! That was cool. All right, so it shot up, I'd say maybe 80 to 100 feet and then exploded. Did a nice little puff of smoke. Let's see how it reacts in liquid nitrogen. I'm gonna toss the casing in there as well. Just let it cool down. Looks like this might work. Oh. Whoa! That is so funny. Did you see what happened? It just did this little pop and the thing just went flicking around, flipping around, busted, and it was like half the height that it would normally go. It was just like, pew! A lot less dramatic than I was expecting. I was thinking maybe the whole thing would explode and shatter out here on the road, but nope, just boop, pew! Mini fireworks. All right, green's next. Light it up. There it goes, look at that. Boom. Man, that only went about 50 feet high, like 40, 50 feet high. I think the trend we're seeing here is that liquid nitrogen makes everything go slower, including fireworks. I'm impressed they even lit off at all. I was expecting the fuse to go out, but it did light off and it just didn't pack as much of a punch. I wonder if you did the opposite and had really hot fireworks, if they'd go off even faster. That might be an experiment for a future video. Last experiment, guys, we are down to this bad boy. This is a 10-shot aerial that we're gonna submerge and light off at once. Now, what do you think is gonna happen? Post your predictions down in the comments below. I personally am thinking it's gonna go off with a little bit of gusto, but what's gonna happen to the firework itself? Is it still gonna explode in the air, or is it gonna fall down to the ground before it goes off? We're taking a bit of a risk, but we're doing it all for fun and for your entertainment. All right, here we go, guys, last dip of the day. Oh, wow. The paper is expanding on the top. That's odd. I would expect the opposite effect. And it's floating. I think there's some kind of a gas in there. I wonder if that's just all the air being pushed to the top. Like if we pop that, if the air could get out and it would sink. Soaking fireworks in our orange nitrogen, no big deal. All right guys, moment of truth. We got big kahuna here. And what I love about this is when I look down inside the container, you can actually see liquid nitrogen boiling inside of the mortar tubes, which is really cool. It's gonna add a little flare, I think, when they take off. Here we go, moment of truth. Look at all that nitrogen spilling out the bottom. That's awesome. Whoa. Man, I should leave that in. That's just cool. Like, froze my gloves though. Gotta warm that back up. There we go. All that nitrogen spilling out. We're gonna set that, light it off, and run away. It's burning. I don't hear anything happening. So check this out. The fuse actually stopped just short of the container. It burned out right here and didn't make it in. So we're gonna light that and hope that it goes in and lights off some of these aerials. Oh, boom. It's gonna explode. Oh no, it didn't. That was a little sketchy. Come check it out, come check it out. So what just happened? So the fuse made it in there and it actually did shoot off the first aerial, and it just only went about 20 feet in the air, and then it came down, landed on the ground, and spun out over here. I'm actually really, really glad that that didn't explode, because if it did, it would have been on the ground, and that's a lot more dangerous than up in the air. And what's kind of interesting is it looks like the gunpowder fell out here. Like, it actually looked like it tried to light off, but it didn't actually explode. Too cold? Let's see what's inside. Oh yeah, see, everything's still in there. That's ready to go. All that gunpowder, all those stars, it just didn't actually light off. But I think this is a pretty good place to stop. We know these things aren't gonna shoot up high enough to actually go off in the air, and I certainly don't want them going off on the ground. So now the question really becomes how to dispose of these. I think what we're gonna do is save this for a future video where we crack all these things open, pour them into a ball of tin foil, and light them off like we did the crackle ball experiment from last year. So if you wanna see that, let me know in the comments below. Should we combine all these into one giant crackle ball experiment? And of course, a super big thanks to our friend Thomas Dopkowski for suggesting this experiment in the comments. Go ahead and check your YouTube inbox, Thomas, or send you 25 bucks. So there you have it, guys. Now you know what happens when you put fireworks into liquid nitrogen. They go off a lot less dramatically. But it was still a great experiment and good times hanging out with you. And I'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. You know what? That sounds a lot louder when you're standing next to it. I can't hear out of my right ear.